All men shied away from me because of my thick mustache. Except for a handsome guy from the gym.
You are perfect. You have no idea how long I've been looking for you.
Right on our first date, John proposed to win the Olympic Games together. He knew well that a mustache on a girl's face meant a high level of testosterone in the body.
It's your superpower. Trust me. Your physique and my coaching experience are a perfect match.
I thought he only needed me for training. But John took me to the city hall and we got married. He insisted that I take his last name.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
I leaned toward my new husband, but he turned away, saying that my mustache was prickly.
No time for romance. We have to work hard.
We went outside, and John forbade me from getting into the car. Instead, he told me to drag it straight to the gym. I asked if it was possible to postpone such physical exertion, at least for a couple of days, until my period ended.
What if you have your period during the Olympics? Will you ask them to put the competition on hold?
I did not argue with the man who believed in me. At the gym, I followed all of John's instructions and went over to him, expecting a small kiss. However, he pushed me away and yelled.
Do something really worthwhile first.
Coming back from the training exhausted, I asked my husband if I had earned some tenderness that day. He replied that I needed a good rest and went to sleep in another room. Sometimes, John would spend the whole night somewhere else.
I need to work on a new coaching technique. Do not wait for me. Go to bed. Bye.
One day, I noticed that he entered someone else's locker room. I thought my husband got the wrong door, but when I went inside, I realized that I was superfluous there. John was hugging a gymnast girl and wasn't embarrassed at all. He said it was the coaching technique he told me about.
I want to awaken competitive anger in you. Win the competition, and you will get a nice bonus.
Scared of losing him, I decided to give my husband what he wanted. I was about to lift a record-breaking weight. Adding the right amount of weight plates to the barbell, I lowered it to my chest, took a few breaths, and my vision got blurry all of a sudden.
Stop. Push it. Come on. Push. Push.
I heard my husband's instructions, but I couldn't follow them. Coming to my senses, I already knew what could happen. John would leave me for not living up to his expectations. Then, a miracle took place. My husband said he wanted to have a baby with me. I even cried. He finally appreciated my efforts. I cooked a romantic dinner at home, put on some pretty clothes, lit candles, and opened a bottle of wine. But John behaved as usual, just like at the gym. He forbade from drinking wine and criticized my food.
What were you thinking? There is no protein on the table, but a lot of carbohydrates.
John put out the candles and told me to take off my clothes. A month later, I went to my husband with the news.
Oh.
When he found out about the pregnancy, he was over the moon. I had never seen him so happy.
I hope you understand that is a huge responsibility.
John found a doctor who monitored my pregnancy. He went to every appointment with me and literally worshipped my stomach. At the same time, John showed no mercy for me at the gym. He doubled the physical exertion. I trusted him because he wouldn't risk the health of his wife and baby. 2 months later, I got my first gold medal. My husband was satisfied.
Finally, this marriage has paid off. My name is on the top of the scoreboard.
John said that to fully enjoy the moment, he was only missing a beautiful victory in the bedroom. I blushed when he said that and made it clear that I was ready. However, John went to the bedroom with that gymnast girl instead of me. I decided to endure that humiliation as well, for the sake of our child. The next day, my husband took me to the hospital, not for a checkup, but to get rid of the baby. According to him, the fetus had done its job. I didn't understand. I thought it was a mean prank. But then he pointed to a paragraph in a scientific article.
During the third month of pregnancy, your body reached its peak. It became super hardy and brought us the gold.
John said he'd do it again next time. Knock me up right before the Olympics. I wanted to object, but suddenly, the door opened, and the doctor invited us into his office. I stated that I was not going to get rid of the baby, but the doctor supported my husband. He claimed that the huge stress my body had experienced could adversely affect the health of the fetus. Lost in thought, I asked John to get me that article. And there it was, my doctor's name at the bottom. I realized that he was in cahoots with my husband, just using me as a lab rat. I got up and walked toward the exit. John stopped me for a long time and didn't even try to change his tactics.
You can't leave. Your body does not belong to you. I put so much time and effort into it.
He only left me alone when the mustache disappeared from my face. After giving birth, my testosterone levels returned to normal. Right before my eyes, John started looking for a new victim. But to no avail, as I did my best to make him famous. The girls recoiled from him as if he had the plague. Soon after, I found a man who looked at me the right way. I was a complete person to him. Not a mean to achieve his goals. You never fully see how toxic someone is until you breathe fresher air.